This is my house.
Really?
You got a house? Get out!
My house, yeah.
So it's been a while. It's been a while.
Boys is back, baby.
It has been a very long time, almost a year, or 10 months, something like that. Now I know the number one question, well, probably two questions is, where have I been? That's probably the number one question, which is fair. The next question is, what have I been doing or what is next? So that might be three, it doesn't matter. Where have I been? So I was gone for so long because during that time I was in a relationship and it took a lot of time to actually be there in that person's life, and she also had kids, so I wanted to be around, so I sort of had to put the YouTube to the back burner. I felt like it was taking up too much time, and then when I would go to see her and the family, I would like sneak off upstairs, and then I'm editing while everyone's downstairs. It wasn't building a healthy family dynamic or showing them that I was fully committed and I was fully there. That's why I put down the camera for so long. But now I'm not in that relationship anymore. And you know, life goes on. So that is what I've been doing. That's what I was doing for such a long time. That's why I never made a video. That's why. And another thing, I don't think, well, they probably wouldn't care. But just having, just walking around, even when I was with them, just walking around with the camera and then having them always on camera, I didn't want to do that to them, honestly. So that's another reason. Now I'm back with the vlogging. I don't know if I'm going to do this every single day, but I will do this enough so that I'm just not gone for months at a time. Besides that, I'm back into the arts. So for those of you who don't know, I'm an actor. So I'm in that world right there. So right now I'm directing a play. Well, I have three plays coming up. I'm directing one. I have two more to direct. I'm also in a short film. I also finished a series, and I am also in pre-rehearsal for another production that is coming up. We're in talks about it, trying to figure it out how this film is going to work. So that's what I've been doing right now. Staying busy, making money doing that. Also, this is just my house. This is just my house. This is the story behind this house right here. First of all, I'm sorry to my family. I didn't tell anyone that I had this house. So if you're watching this right now, surprise, I have a house. I will send you the address. This is how I got the house. When I was with my ex, she had kids. So I was saving up aggressively and I was working, doing other things just to save as much as I possibly could to buy a bigger house to house everyone. That's what I was doing. That's why I was working so hard. That's another reason why I put the camera down. I was just saving as much as I could so that when it was time to buy a house, it would go as smooth as possible. When that didn't work out, I didn't want to stay in my apartment. So I'm like, let me just buy a house so that way I can put my money into something. Because apartment, you're just throwing away money with rent every day. With a mortgage, at least you're putting that money into something, so when you're ready to sell, you get a lot of it back, especially if you fix it up, which I have done. The reason why I didn't tell my family that I had this is because I knew that they were going to want to help me fix it up, pretty much. It took me about 2 months to do all of the work that you're about to see, because I'm definitely going to show you, Daddy. I'm definitely going to show you, Daddy. It took me about 2 months to finish all of this work. And during me staying busy, it helped me pretty much get over or heal from that relationship. So that's why I wanted to do everything by myself, so I could just be in here with my thoughts, say, talk to God, thank Him for everything that He's done in my life, and really just slowly get over that process. If I would have had because my family's so big and everyone's so handy and talented, if I would have had them come in, it would have been done like in a weekend, maybe 4 days, everything would have been done. But I just took my time. And you know what? I'm glad I did that. I don't regret doing that. I don't regret it at all. So let's get into everything that I've done with this house. This isn't even everything, because I didn't film everything. But this is some good stuff, I guess. Let's get into it. Now, I'm meeting with my realtor. She actually got me like this nice goodie bag. I'm pretty sure it's the least she could do. I made her a lot of money that day. Fun fact, I've never signed so many papers before a day in my life. This had to be the most signatures I've ever placed down. But I read everything. Because I don't want to be signing my life away, like signing, you know, something crazy. I like to do things and get them done and really not look at accomplishments. And I really don't impress myself at all. But today, or that day, was a very good day. And I had to pat myself on the back. Good job, Ryan. This backyard was horrendous. Though it's small, it was very mighty. I wanted to just start with the backyard first. I don't know why, it was just bothering me. I pulled up those pieces of logs that separated the grass from the concrete. I don't know what the point of those were there for, so I just picked them up. I moved these stones. My mom wants these stones. Mom, you can definitely have them. I'll be dropping them off very soon. So I went out, got on Craigslist, got a lawnmower, and got to work. Once that was done, I just had to level everything out, and then I think it's time to get some paint now. Now I need to go and get the paint so I can start painting. See, I told you. Now, with most of this paint, it was from my mom. She had some already at her house, so I just snatched it up, and it was a plus because it was white, and I just needed white. They had a spray gun, but that spray gun was not working how I thought it should be working. I got paint all over the hardwood floors, but it's a water-based paint, so it was easy to get up. Growing up, we always had to paint a lot, so then I went back to the basics with just a brush and a paint pan. Look at those arms right there. Guns glowing. Every wall in this house was a different color. You can even see in the kitchen right now. They were just different colors. Now it's time to move on to the bathroom. Moving faucets, because everything was very, very old. Very old looking. I wanted to sort of modernize it. Luckily, these faucets, I didn't have to pay for these faucets because they were brand new and they were under both of the sinks in the bathrooms. So I was able to just pull those out. I mean, they were brand new. I just slapped them on. I ordered these fixtures on Amazon just to, again, modernize it, make it look just more updated. The bathroom was pretty much a breeze. And then the door was coming, the door was scraping the floor, so I just took it outside and then cut the bottom half just so that it would swing right, so it wouldn't grab on everything. I'm not gonna lie, look at my knees. I had a problem with that door. My knees were all ashy, but it worked. See there? It worked. Again, just updating it with the fixtures. These lights went on Amazon, I think were maybe $20 each. I had to order three of them. I forgot to take this out. I actually didn't have to take that out, and I figured that out once I took it out and I tried to install the new light. That was just bad. I shouldn't have done that. But I got it in there. It worked. It was a hassle. I was doing this every single day when I came home from work, just getting up there and just slowly taking it one project at a time. I even ended up doing the outside, the porch light, because I didn't like the way that looked. I got this little one in here. It gets the job done. Next, the doorknobs. Everything was that old brass look that looks super dumb. I got rid of those. I hate the way gold doorknobs look, so I just threw these stainless steel ones. Even the dresser, I'm sorry, the closet. Even the closet, it has gold knobs. So I just switched those out and everything's good. Now everything else is miscellaneous. Cable guy coming in, steamed the curtains so they're not wrinkled. Now it's time for my art. I've always wanted nice art pieces, but I didn't want to spend that much. So my mother had some old canvases laying down that she probably got from the Ross or TJ Maxx, loved those stores. So I took those and then I painted over them white and just decided to do my own art project. Now, I ended up doing a few trial and errors. Some things I liked, some things I didn't. Then I started exploring with the plaster. I've seen some plaster art and I like the way it looks, so I started exploring with that as well. I highly encourage you, if you want just custom pieces, to just go out and do it yourself. This canvas, again, you can find one of these at the Goodwill store for maybe $15. Just paint it white, and then this bucket of plaster was only $10. Once I made my designs and then I let it dry, then I took a smaller roller and just rolled over it just to get some color into it. I didn't want it to be all white, so the color, I think it looks really good. Now for the frames, I used two things. One, I found some wood, so I ended up just cutting that wood down to size and then sanding it to make a frame for the bigger piece of art. For the second thing, the woman who was here before me, she had some old paint sticks. So I just took those paint sticks and glued them together to make a border and then sort of just nailed them to the side of the smaller pieces of art. Hanging up this TV, I was a little skeptical about that TV because it was so big, and on that bare wall before I even painted it anything, it just looked too big. I almost took it back. They left this entertainment system and I just didn't want to throw it away. So I decided to just cut it down to size and make a hanging shelf with that entertainment system. So that's exactly what I did. So this is some of the wood that I used for the frame. I found this wood and it was in pretty good condition. I cut it in half, took the nails out, and just did what I had to do. I pretty much trial and errored it the entire way. That saw, I thought I broke the original saw, but I didn't, and I didn't find that out until later. So I ended up spending like $100 at Lowe's to rent their table saw when mine wasn't even broken. I ended up painting the walls. I couldn't decide if I wanted to do green or gray. I ended up going with black, which was crazy. And then I wanted to do a nice flat wall. So I cut down that wood that I used, sanded it down, stained it, and then hung it up. Next was the kitchen. The kitchen, I wanted to just get rid of that old wood look. So I took everything down, labeled it, degreased it, and then just put some paint to it. I got this paint from my mom's house, and this was the wrong paint, but ended up working because I like the way it looked. I was actually supposed to do a two-tone paint, but I forgot to paint the other side of the cabinet, so they're all one color now. Then I sprayed the hinges black with, I think, $3 can of spray paint. Now it's time to replace these old appliances. This by far was probably the most difficult thing to install. This over the stove vent, it was terrible. I was ready to burn the house down after this. But I got it in there. Hey. Ceiling fan had to go. Had to go. Just white. Most of this was just updating the fixtures. You'd be surprised how just changing something out can make it look 1,000 times better. Something that I wanted to add in, I had this ottoman and I didn't like the way the color, it didn't match the couch. So I ended up just taking one of the cushions of the couch, taking it to a fabric store, finding the fabric that comes closest to it, and then just wrapping the ottoman in that.
No, I don't need a bag.
That fabric was only like, I think $30 for all of that fabric. I spent about $1,400, which isn't a lot at all when you're talking about like a house and redoing everything, because some people can't even do the kitchen over for less than $5,000 because appliances and all these other things, but I did everything myself. So this is a list of everything that I bought, I paid for, blah, 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 all this right here. You can, I don't know, just pause it and look at it if you want. Ended up being like almost $2,000. But then I sold a lot of the things that were already in here as well. So the stove, the dishwasher, my old TV, and just other little things that aren't on this list because I just couldn't remember them all. But it just brought it down to about $1,377. And yeah. Proud of myself, pat on the back. I'm probably gonna talk about the breakup and other things pertaining to such. I have a few story time videos coming up, so hit that subscribe button, like, hit that notification bell so you know when I'm posting videos. Also, PS, sorry again to my family for not telling you all, but now you know. I know this isn't the way that you wanted to find out. I'm sorry, I really am. I was going through something. What do you want me to do? But that's it, and I'll see you on another one.